Hello students, this is another spotting activity for you class 12. Here you have to identify the stages of the gamete development, that is the T.S. of testis and T.S. of ovary through permanent slide. So let's start the activity. So what is the principle of this activity? Gametes are the haploid sex cells involved in the process of sexual reproduction. The process of formation of male and female gametes, that are the sperms in the male and ova in the female, is called gametogenesis. The process of gametogenesis takes place in different organs in male and female. It includes certain phases for their development and maturation. In males, it occurs in testis, and in females, it occurs in ovary. Both of these organs are primary sex organs. The testis. Testis are primary male sex organs. A pair of testis are present in the scrotum lying outside the abdomen. Sperms in the male body are formed by the process of spermatogenesis in the testis. There are four main phases of spermatogenesis. They are the multiplication phase, growth phase, maturation phase and differentiation phase. So what are the identifying characteristics of the TS of mammalian testis? There are major three identifying characters, that are the seminiferous tubules are easily seen in the cross section of the testis. Secondly, the presence of large cells called Sertoli cells is the characteristic feature of this slide. Thirdly, the presence of interstitial cells or lady cells is evident. Now the general characteristics. The transverse section of the testis shows many seminiferous tubules embedded in the interstitial tissues. These appear as coiled circular structures. Each seminiferous tubule is lined by its inside by germinal epithelium, which divides mitotically to produce male germ cells called spermatogonia. Various stages of development of sperm from the spermatogonia are seen from periphery to the lumen of the seminiferous tubule. The sequence of the stages of its development are like spermatogonia undergo mitosis to form primary spermatocyte, which is also 2n in number, that is the diploid, which undergo meiosis 1 to form the secondary spermatocyte, which become the haploid. This haploid secondary spermatocyte undergo meiosis 2 and form spermatids, and further the spermatids get development and undergo changes and form spermatozoa. So all these stages are clearly visible in the TS of testis. The mature sperms are present in the center and primary spermatocyte in the middle layer. The Sertoli cells are prominent pyramid-shaped cell found in between the germinal cells. These cells provide nutrition to the developing spermatozoa. Leydig cells are seen in the interstitial tissues. They produce the hormone testosterone responsible for development of male secondary sexual characters. Now let's talk about the ovary. Ovaries are primary sex organ found in the female mammals. These are paired, almond-shaped, solid and grayish structure found in the female body. Anatomically, these are differentiated into germinal epithelium, tunica albuginea and cortex and medulla. Formation of ova, that is oogenesis, take place inside the ovary. The events involved in this process of oogenesis are multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase, that you have already learned in your theory part. So here I'm not discussing about it in details. For both the activity for spotting, you need to take a permanent slide and fix the slide on the stage of the microscope, and then observe the slide of testis and ovary first under the low power magnification and then under high power magnification. Now you can just draw a label diagram as seen in the sections of both the testis and ovary. So the identifying characteristics of the TS of mammalian ovary. The presence of graafian follicle is characteristic feature of mammalian ovary. Each graafian follicle contains one ovum and a cavity called antrum. The general characteristics of this activity are, for the TS of mammalian ovary, the section of mammalian ovary shows the mass of tissues lined up bigerminal epithelium. The stroma is made up of connective tissues, blood vessels and nerve fibers. Various circular structures seen in the stroma are graafian follicle in their various developmental stages, like the primary follicle, the secondary oocyte stage. In the latter stage of follicular development, a fluid-filled cavity called antrum appears, which separates the ovum and the cells around it except at one point. At this cavity enlarges, the graafian follicle becomes ready to release the ovum. The mature follicle ruptures and releases ovum. This is called ovulation. The ruptured follicle form corpus luteum, which is an endocrine tissue, and release progesterone, that is the pregnancy hormone. All the stages of oogenesis cannot be seen at the same time. However, they can be seen when an ovary is observed for entire duration of menstrual cycle. Precautions of this activity are: the prepared permanent slide should be handled carefully. It should be observed initially under the low and then the high power magnification of the microscope. And the diagram of the T.S. of testis and ovary should be drawn and should be labeled properly in order to understand the detailed structures. My dear students, it was all about the T.S. of testis and ovary, the spotting activity. In the next video, I will discuss about the pedigree analysis. This is also another spotting or minor activity for you. Stay tuned with me for the further videos. If you have liked it, then do share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.